Welcome to the Forecheck. I'm Carley Johnston, joined by Art Regner. Art, thanks for being here.
My pleasure as always.
The Red Wings kick off their week on Tuesday as they play host to the Tampa Bay Lightning. The Lightning have been killing it this season. They have Nikita Kucherov and Braden Point, who are over 30 points. How are the Red Wings going to combat them up front?
Well, I would think, you know, they probably want to play a little bit of a puck possession game and dump the puck into the Tampa zone and then make the defense make some plays. But this team is loaded. Let's be honest. Point is come really out of nowhere. I mean, he was a good player, but he really has come into his own. You know, he's a complete player. He's tough as nails, and he gets the job done. And then what can you say about Kucherov? He's probably the best goal scorer in the NHL. He can fire the shot. He knows what he's doing. He's dangerous from virtually anywhere on the ice. So up front, they're very, very good. And don't forget, we haven't even mentioned Steven Stamkos, who, of course, is the captain of the team and has been getting it done. And if he stays healthy, you know, Tampa's just deep up front. They're just very, very deep up front.
Absolutely. Stamkos is over 20 points. And then someone else who is racking up points is Ryan McDonagh on the back end.
Well, Ryan McDonagh was traded for, and he's a former captain of the New York Rangers. And, you know, this guy is a leader. He is, you know, again, I keep saying tough, but he definitely is such a complete player and great in the room. And they needed that because their other big stud on the blue line is Victor Hedman, who has had some injuries this year and has been missed some time. But Hedman, in my mind, is, if not the best defenseman in the NHL, one of the best. He's going to win the Norris Trophy. So with McDonagh and Hedman on the back end, I mean, Tampa, again, why are they favored to be one of the teams that win the Stanley Cup? Because they're deep, talented, and very good.
And it's a good thing they have a strong decor because they're without Vasilevsky and that.
Yeah, Vasilevsky is one of the best young goaltenders in the world and one of the best in the NHL. That was a weird injury. I mean, he broke his foot in practice and he's going to be out for a while. But Louis Domingue, of all people, has really stepped in. The Tampa acquired him last year, I believe. And, you know, he is a good backup. And he has played very, very well. He will be a challenge in net. But I guess it goes to show you with Domingue and net is that when he was with Arizona, he was a bad goalie. Now he's with Tampa Bay, and suddenly he's a good goalie. So, you know, I mean, that's just the way it works out. So Tampa's going to be a formidable opponent. They always have been. They seem to own the Red Wings, much like the Bruins have lately. But Detroit has played very, very well, and I think they're going to give them a game Tuesday night at Little Caesars Arena.
Well, let's hope so. And then on Thursday, the Red Wings will be in Toronto taking on the Maple Leafs. They have a strong front line with Mitch Marner and Jonathan Tavares, who have been really chugging along without Austin Matthews.
Well, certainly. I mean, you know, the schedule maker hasn't been kind of the Red Wings. They're facing the two top teams in the Atlantic Division, Tampa Bay and Toronto, back-to-back. But Toronto's loaded. You know, Mike Babcock has them going right now. And Mitch Marner, who everyone thought was a power play specialist, has really come on and shown that he is a complete hockey player. And John Tavares, you know, he came home. You know, he's all those years with the Islanders, but as soon as he had a chance to bolt to Toronto. So they're a very, very good hockey club. They score a lot of goals, much like Tampa Bay. You know, when Steve Yzerman was there, the uniforms are very, very similar now. He kind of, you know, so the Red Wings might think, my gosh, we're playing, you know, mirror images of one another because Toronto and Tampa are definitely the class of the Atlantic Division.
And then on the blue line, they have Morgan Rielly, who has just as many points as some of the forwards in the league.
Morgan Rielly, this is the type of guy Mike Babcock loves because he can ride him and ride him. His ice time is through the roof. He's a leader. He's played a long time. And, you know, I think Red Wing fans should take solace because Rielly was a guy who took a little bit of seasoning. I mean, they always knew he was going to be good, but he's finally reached his level, and what a tremendous talent. He could win the Norris Trophy this year, especially playing in a Canadian city. Because we know the Canadian press will all vote for him. He might have it in the bag. But then in goal, Frederik Andersen. This guy, since they acquired him from the Anaheim Ducks, Andersen's a great goaltender. When he is on, you know, Toronto is almost unbeatable because they're such a complete team. And, you know, Mike Babcock has a lot of faith in him. And when Andersen, you know, when he's sputtered a little bit, they're not quite as good because he lets in kind of the soft goal. We're going to have to hope that maybe he's doing Christmas shopping or something. He's got Christmas on his mind because he's going to be very, very good Thursday night against the Red Wings.
And now switching gears from Jonathan Tavares' current team to his former team, the New York Islanders, who will be here at Little Caesars Arena on Saturday night. They've been surprisingly good since his departure.
Well, it all begins with their new coach, Barry Trotz. He's a defensive genius. He won the Cup last year with the Washington Capitals. And the reason why the Islanders are so good is because they play defense now. Red Wing fans may remember last year that one game where they scored like 8 goals in the third period to come back and beat Detroit. You know, Matt Barzal, who is really playing very well, he's, you know, a goal scorer. He's a complete player. He's going to pose a problem for the Red Wings. And then Josh Bailey, who has always been a good player, kind of had a coming out party last year. He leads them in scoring right now, and he is an excellent hockey player who, you know, maybe a bit of a late bloomer. And then a kid that I like, a former Notre Dame Fighting Irishman there, is Anders Lee. He's starting off a little slow, but once he heats up, they're going to be pretty good up front. So you throw Trotz into the mix, they're playing defense, they're a pretty good team.
And on the back end, they might not have the biggest names, but they have Nick Leddy and Scott Mayfield.
Right. Scott Mayfield is the offensive-minded defenseman for the Islanders, if you can call him that. I mean, he leads them in scoring as a defenseman right now. So he is the guy that kind of will start the rush, make that first pass out of the zone. He's pretty good. And then, of course, Nick Leddy, who, former Blackhawk, now a longtime Islander, he is the stabilizing force back there. He can give you offense when needed, but he's more of a controlling-type defenseman, wants to control the play, but really wants to make sure that they're playing good defense. And I know Barry Trotz really appreciates that. And then in net, Thomas Greiss, who was not very good last year, but because they're playing team defense, has been outstanding this year. You know, the New York still probably gives up a little more shots than Trotz wants, but Greiss has been there, and I think he has confidence in the players playing in front of him now that they're going to play defense. You know, New York's a weird team, the Islanders are. Even when the Red Wings were tremendous, you know, perennial Stanley Cup powerhouses, the Islanders always found a way to beat them. It's kind of switched right now, so this should be a pretty competitive game Saturday night at Little Caesars.
Each week we've been highlighting a Red Wings prospect, and this week we're going to talk about Filip Hronek, who was with the Detroit Red Wings earlier this season but is now with the Grand Rapids Griffins. Art, how has he been doing in GR?
Well, I'm sure he was disappointed to be sent back to Grand Rapids after starting the season in Detroit because he was the odds-on favorite to actually make the team this year. But Filip was up here. He was sent back to Grand Rapids because he needed to play. They wanted him to play in all situations. He's now kind of found it. He last year he was on the AHL All-Rookie team. He can captain a power play, which he has done very, very well. And just recently, he set a record. He scored back-to-back overtime goals for the Grand Rapids Griffins. So this is a complete hockey player, but this is somebody that I think next year he'll make a legitimate run at being on the Detroit blue line.
Fans, if you're coming to the game on Tuesday night against the Lightning here at Little Caesars Arena, make sure to get here early. The first 7,500 fans in attendance are going home with a Michael Rasmussen bobblehead thanks to our friends at Coca-Cola. For tickets to that game and the game on Saturday night against the Islanders, head over to the Xfinity box office or DetroitRedWings.com. That's it for this week's The Forecheck. Art, love having you on.
It's my pleasure, Carly. I'll do it all the time.
We'll see you next time.